for those students that are new here, I'm Mr. Robinson, and I am your PE teacher. And every week, I'll be sending out a classroom workout for you to do sometime during the week in your class. My goal here is to increase our fitness. And if you remember from last school year, physical activity makes you a better learner. It kind of wakes your body up and gets your brain ready to learn. You'll be more attentive, you'll remember more things, and be a problem solver. So let's get started. So let's start with some arm swings. Right where you're at, go ahead and swing your arms back and forth, kind of like you give yourself a big hug. Swing those arms back and forth. Keep going. And let's keep those arms out. Let's just do some arm circles forward. So now most of these moves you'll be familiar with. If there ever is a new move or something that's a little tricky, and let's go the other way. Like I said, if it's a little tricky, remember, just do your best. It takes courage to try new things, so like I said, just do the very best you can do. Let's do a few more arm circles. And let's stop there. So let's just start with the side step. So we're just gonna step side to side. This is a basic move. I'll add more things to this today and as the year goes on, but this is just a basic side step move we'll start with. So you've got that down. So as we're sidestepping, let's try bringing our knee up. So it looks like this. We step knee up, keep sidestepping and bringing that knee up as high as you can. Keep going. Now if you've got that, I want you to try and touch your knee with your hand. So I'm gonna go my opposite hand to my opposite knee going across my body, like that. So now I'm touching my knee with my hand. Give that a try. Might be a little confusing at first, but keep working at it, you'll get it. Again, bring that knee up as high as you can. Try and touch it with your hand. Just a few more of those. 3, 2, and 1. Let's try some jumping jacks. Here we go. Keep going. Let's try 5 more. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So I have my desk here, just like you have in your classroom, and we're gonna do some desk push-up. So I've got my hands on my desk, I put my feet back, and I'm gonna bring my chest down to my desk and push up. So we're doing our desk push-ups. Bringing your chest down as far as you can and then pushing all the way up. Let's try 5 more. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's hold right here. This will be our desk plank, and we'll do this for 20 seconds. You can count with me if you want. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Nice job with those planks. So now we're gonna do some squats. So we're gonna put your feet shoulder width apart, and you're gonna pretend like you're sitting in a chair. So go all the way down, pretend you're sitting in that chair, and come up. Go down and up. I like to put my hands out for balance when I'm doing a squat. This helps me not fall over. Make sure you go all the way down like you're in a pretend chair. Nice job, looking good. Let's do 3 more. 2, and 1. So again, let's keep our feet apart. We're gonna do some windmills. So put your hands out, and you're gonna bring your hand across your body and touch your opposite toe, and then back up. Now your other hand comes across, touch your toe, and back up. Keep going, this is a windmill. So this is a good exercise, working on your stomach muscles, and you're kind of stretching your legs as you go. Keep going. See if you can keep your legs straight as you reach all the way down and touch that toe. 2, last 1. Next, we're gonna do some lunges. So for a lunge, I'll turn sideways here. All you gotta do is step out. You're gonna bring your knee as close to the ground as you can without touching it, and then step back. Then you step forward with the other foot and step back. So this is a lunge. Just keep stepping forward and back. Step forward and back. Make sure it's a big step forward and back. Keep going. Make sure you go down as far as you can. Just a few more. Congratulations, you've made it to your cool down. So let's try and calm our body down because we just worked out hard, we're breathing hard, we got maybe a little sweat going on. So let's calm our body down. So we're just gonna start with bouncing on one foot. And as you're bouncing, if you have to hold on to your desk for balance, that's fine. But if you can, try to balance without touching anything. And as we're balancing, let's try and calm ourselves down. So maybe take a big breath in and breathe out. And let's balance on the other foot. Again, if you have to touch something or hold on to a desk while you're balancing, that's fine. You'll get better. Big breath in. Breathe out. And let's now have one leg down. Bring the other leg behind you. We'll do a little stretch. So I'll turn sideways so you can see. Just grab your leg behind you. Again, if you have to hold your desk, that's fine. We're just gonna stretch out our leg muscles a little bit. Again, stretching out and calming our bodies down. And switch to the other foot. Try not to fall over on this one. And we'll do one more stretch. So let's have both feet down. We're gonna reach down as far as we can to the floor. We want to keep our legs straight, so don't bend your knees. Just keep your legs straight and reach down as far as you can. And if you can't quite touch your feet, that's okay. You'll get better. If you can touch your feet, or if you can touch your toes, that's awesome. And some of you are probably going all the way down and touching the floor. That means you have really good flexibility. That's fantastic. Just hold it there. And slowly come on up. Give your legs a shake. Whew! Awesome job, everyone. I'll see you next time. Bye.